above every situation, above every circumstance this morning, God. You're greater than all of that. We give you praise in advance for what you're going to do. In Jesus' name, everybody shout it. Slap somebody a high five and tell them, let's praise Jesus.
Go to
to the left, if he goes to the right, go.
We're gonna clap.
We're gonna clap, 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 clap in the river now. Clap, 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 clap in the river. If he goes to the left, we go to the left. If he goes to the right, we go to.
We're gonna jump.
We're gonna jump, jump. Go to,
we're gonna clap,
gonna clap, 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 clap in the river now. Clap, 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 clap in the river. If he goes to the left, we go to the left. If he goes to the right, we go to the right. We're gonna jump. If he goes to the left, we go to the left. If he goes to the right, we go.
We're gonna shout,
we're gonna shout, 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 shout in the river now. Shout, 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 everybody.
One more time, come on, lift up your voice. Come on, somebody shout, hallelujah. Oh, somebody shout, he's alive. Serve a God that is alive this morning. He's not dead. God is alive. Let's dance together.
Come on. Let heaven roar and fire fall.
the crown with the sound of revival.
My God.
My God's not dead. He's surely alive. He's living on the inside, roaring like a lion. God's not dead. He's surely alive. He's living on the inside, roaring like a lion. God's not dead. He's surely alive. He's living on the inside, roaring like a lion. God's not dead. He's surely alive. He's living on the inside, roaring like a lion. He's roaring like a lion.
Somebody give him praise this morning.
Through you the blind will see. Through you the mute will sing. Through you the dead will rise. Through you our hearts will praise. Through you the darkness flees. Through you my heart screams, I am free.
Somebody shout, I'm free.
I am free.
Come on, sing through you.
Through you the blind will see. Through you the mute will sing. Through you the dead will rise. Through you our hearts will praise. Through you the darkness flees. Through you my heart screams, I am free. I am free.
Shout for freedom this morning. Hallelujah. You are good, Jesus. Oh, somebody shout, I'm free. And whom the Son sets free is free indeed. God,
God, is because you laid down your life that we can be free. What other God has done that? The word says no greater love has anyone than to lay down his life for the ones he loves. And Jesus laid down his life because he first loved us. You may be here this morning and you may feel unloved. You may feel like there's not a God who cares about you, but I'm here to declare to you this morning that God loves you. He loved you before you were clean, but he loved you enough to say that you don't have to stay that way. Oh, because he first loved you this morning. He first loved you this morning. Oh, how he loves. Oh, how he loves. Sing this. And he loves us. Oh, how he loves us. Oh. This morning, somebody's here. You're thinking, how could he love me after all I've done? I'm here to tell you that when he was on the cross, he said, Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they're doing. And he took the sins of the world, past, present, and future, upon his back, and he was nailed to the cross of Calvary. And he said, I know they're going to fall. I know they're going to fail. But I still love them. I still love them. Enough to die. Enough to die. Oh, because yeah. close your eyes and just picture him. I don't want us to be here out of routine this morning. I want us to meet with Jesus. Come on. Where two or three are gathered, he's in our midst, church. And I'm telling you that he is in our midst this morning.
Oh, he's here today.
Oh, and he's here to meet with you. Listen, this is a meeting place today. Come on, God is here to meet with you. Says his eyes are like fire and there's a sword in his hand. The Bible paints a picture of the sword coming straight out of his mouth. He's a mighty God. He's all powerful. But he's also so full of love, so full of compassion, so full of grace. And he's saying, I love you.
So much that I laid down my life for you. I love you.
Those on the platform, I don't know, it's for anybody, and you just say, I want to respond to his love this morning. I want you to just make your way to these altars. I believe these altars are a meeting place today. Come on, anywhere in this room, if you just feel the unction, if you just feel a tug this morning, you say, I want to respond to his love this morning. I believe God is wanting to love on you this morning. Come on. So the altars are open. If you just need to respond to his love this morning, I want you to make your way today. Come on.
I love you so much.
just feel, listen, coming to church is not about coming and singing a few songs together. It's not about coming and hearing a message. It's about coming and meeting with Jesus. So right now, in your own way, wherever you are, however you need to respond to God's love this morning, I want you to just begin to tell him how much you love him. You may say, yeah, but you don't know what I've done this week. It doesn't matter. I want you to begin to tell him how much you love him. Because his love is unconditional. His love is unfailing. His love is unchanging.
Hallelujah. You have won the victory.
could not.
Death could not hold you down.
Hallelujah.
You are the risen King, seated in majesty. You are the risen King.
Come on, death could not.
Death could not hold you down. You are the
comfortable, but I feel like God's presence is here, and I don't want to move. I want to be like Moses was. If your presence doesn't go, I don't go. I don't want to go anywhere right now. His presence is right here. Come on, in this moment. Can we just raise our hands to him all over this room? Come on, all over this room. Like lightning rods. Say, God, I'm here. Come and touch me. I'm here. Come and touch me right now. Right now, I believe somebody's feeling the presence of Jesus right now. Come on, you can feel him just moving through your body right now. I believe that. I believe that God makes his presence manifest to us. And there are moments where you can tangibly feel the presence of Jesus. We serve a God who is alive. He is not dead. He is not a God of the past. He is God of the present. And he's here to meet with us today. And I believe that some of you right now can feel the presence of Jesus. Come on. Soak it in right now. Soak it in right now. Holy Spirit, rain down right now. Rain down right now. God, we throw up our hands like lightning rods as we say, touch us, God. Come down and strike us with your love, God. Come down and strike us with your presence, God. Come down and strike us with your peace, God. Come down and strike us with your healing, God. Come down and strike us with your grace. Different plan for today, but I'm telling you that I'm here for God's plan, not man's plan. I'm here to meet with Jesus. I'm here to meet with the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, do whatever it is you want to do this morning. Holy Spirit, do whatever it is you want to do this morning. Know that he's active in my life. I need to know that he cares about me. I need to know that he's thinking about my situation right now. I need to know that God is working on my behalf. I need to know that he's a friend that sticks closer than the brother. I need to know that he is always for me, that he's not against me. I need to feel him in my life today. If that's you anywhere in this room, real quickly, I want you to slip up your hand anywhere in this room. Slip it up high where I can see. Okay. Yep. Father, right now, I pray that you show your love in a way that can be felt, God. Almost like just a breath of fresh air that's taken in, God. I pray that we will breathe you in this morning. And God, whatever's going on in their life right now, God, the hands that were raised, God, whatever's going on in their life right now, God, I pray that they will feel you working in their midst. That they will leave this place knowing that we serve a God that is alive, that's not dead. A God that's alive and he hears us when we speak. A God that's alive, Lord God, and cares about what we have to say. God, a God that is fighting for us, not against us. Right now, I feel instructed that if you raised your hand, I want you to just take in a deep breath right now in the natural and in the supernatural. It's going to be as if you're just breathing in Jesus. The Bible says your body's the temple of the Holy Spirit. I just want you to breathe him in right now. Just breathe in that presence of God. You have access to it right now. Come on, just breathe in deep. Breathe in deep. I know it may sound silly, but God, all throughout the Word, asks men to do silly things that resulted in the supernatural. So right now, as you breathe, I want you to just breathe him in right now. Come on. I'm telling you, the atmosphere is thick this morning. God, I feel your presence.
good. It's good.
Some of you have been going through a dry season, a desert place. You haven't been feeling God like you used to. You haven't been experiencing God like you used to, and you say, I want to feel Him again. I want to experience Him again. I want to have that same excitement that I once had. I want a renewed excitement to follow Jesus in my life. If that's you this morning, I just feel like I want to invite you to these altars. I'm telling you that it's almost like a river running through these altars. And God is saying that those who have been in a desert place, those who have been going through a dry time in your life, that here is found an oasis where you're going to be refreshed, where you're going to be renewed, and you're going to leave this place with a new, fresh excitement to follow Jesus. So if that's you this morning, you say, I'm in a desert place, I'm in a dry season right now, I want you to come and I want you to find your ways. That doesn't mean you're a bad person, it's just a season in your life. But I'm telling you, so declares the Lord, that your season is about to change. Your season is about to change. Nobody has to lay hands on you. Nobody has to pray for you. I'm telling you in the divine supernatural that your season is about to change. Ooh, if that's you, I want you anywhere in this sanctuary. If that's you, I want you to shout, my season is about to change. My season is about to change. My season is about to change. Say, but if you need to respond to that, I want you to come forward this morning. I want you to believe, God, this is my day. This is the day my season changes. This is the day my season changes. This is the day my season changes. Today is the day. Today is the day. I believe some of you are already up here, but listen, I'm telling you, my day, my season is about to change. God says it's going to happen in the quiet time. You're going to begin to feel my presence again. It's going to happen in the quiet time. You're going to begin to feel me stirring in your life. It's going to happen in your quiet time where you're going to hear me speak again. It's going to be in fact, some of you are going to have a renewed desire to spend more time with the Lord. Some of you are going to have, He's just going to stir up an appetite today. He's going to stir up an appetite that's going to make you crave the things of God. Stir it up, God. So we're like stirring up deep water, stirring up the deep well that's inside of you, and saying that something's about to change. Something's about to happen in Jesus' name. Before we go any farther, if there's anybody here with every eye closed, if anybody's here, you say, I have a need in my life. Let me ask some specifics this morning. If you would say, I have a financial need in my life, and I believe God can meet it, I want you to raise your hand anywhere in this room. I'm not going to embarrass you this morning. Okay. All right. All right. All right. All right. All right. Several hands. If you're here this morning, you say, I have a physical need. I need healing in my body. I want you to raise your hand anywhere in this room. Anywhere in this room. Okay. I see it. And if you're here and you would say, I'm going through a situation right now that's bigger than me and I need God's help. There's something going on in my life and I just need God's help right now. I need you to raise your hand anywhere in this room. Okay. All right. Okay. Now here's what I'd like to do. If you raised your hand for any of those things, I'd like to invite you to just step out into the aisle. That's all. I'm not going to ask you to come to the front. Just step out into the aisle. Just as an act of faith. God always requires an act of faith and an act of obedience. So if that's you, I want you to step out in the aisle wherever you're at. Come on, if you can do that, I believe God's going to begin to work wonders in your life. Okay. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 maybe. Okay. Now here's what I want to do. I believe this. First of all, I seal the atmosphere right now from any demonic activity and transfer right now in Jesus' name. And God, I release the anointing of the Holy Spirit to rest upon your people right now. And I declare this a safe place. A safe place. If you see somebody standing in the aisle, I want you to go and get around them. Kids, you guys included. I want you to find somebody and I want you to pray and believe. It's the faith like a child that can, I believe it's the faith like a child that can move mountains. The Bible says even mustard seed faith can move mountains. I believe sometimes kids have more faith than us adults do. So right now, I want you to just find somebody. Let God lead you this morning. Let him lead you. And I want you to find somebody, and I want you to begin to agree with them for whatever their need is this morning. Whatever their need is this morning. Come on. Holy Spirit, you are welcome. Come on, how many knows that we don't understand why God does things the way he does, but I'm just glad he does it. I'm just glad he does it. We don't understand, God, but we choose you. I don't understand, God, but we choose you. I don't understand why you say when we breathe you in today, God, but I declare in this place that we have breathed in the very presence of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We have breathed in the atmosphere of glory this morning. We have breathed in the atmosphere of glory this morning. And I declare over the lives of your people that they will never, ever be the same. The situations are going to change. That seasons are going to change, that struggles are going to fade away, that chains are going to fall off, that sickness is going to flee, that finances are going to come, God. I pray in Jesus' name that you are God, that you are God in our lives. And God, today as we breathe you in, we breathe in all the goodness that you have to offer, all the goodness that you have to offer. And we declare over our situations, it is finished. Because we serve a God who finishes. We serve a God who finishes what he starts. We serve a God who finishes. We don't serve a God who quits. We don't serve a God who starts well. We serve a God who finishes well. So God, today we choose you. We choose you, Jesus. We choose you, Jesus. Man, I feel strong right now. There may be somebody here that's never accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. You've never made him the Lord of your life. But you said, man, after today, I'm ready. After today, I'm ready. After today, I'm ready. If that's you, I want you to raise your hand anywhere right now. Just say, I'm ready to choose Jesus. I'm ready to choose Jesus, and I'm ready to make him the Lord of my life. If that's you, anywhere in this room, anywhere in this room, or maybe you're here this morning, you say, you know what, I haven't been following Jesus, I haven't been making him the Lord of my life. I may have made a decision a long time ago, but I haven't been living for him, but I want a fresh start today. I want you to raise your hand anywhere in this room, anywhere in this room. Okay, okay, very good. Couple raise their hands, and I want us to all pray right now. Dear Jesus, thank you for loving me. Thank you that you died on the cross for my sins. Thank you that you didn't stay dead, but you rose again on the third day. I thank you that you want me, that you love me enough to allow me to follow you wherever you go. I make you the Lord of my life and my Savior and my very best friend. Forgive me for my sins. Forgive me for slacking up on my walk with you. Help me to choose you and your way every day of my life. And I give you praise in Jesus' name. Everybody said, amen. Can we give the Lord a hand clap of praise? Hallelujah. Now. Now look, the Bible teaches us that when that happens, when that happens, the heavens stop and have an ever-loving party because somebody came to know Jesus. So I believe we got more to offer than that, White Dove. Come on, with everything you got, come on. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! We praise you, Jesus. We praise you, Jesus, that you know better than we know. And we can make plans, but your plans are always better. And so, God, I pray in Jesus' name that every seed that was planted, every need, Lord God, that was represented, we declare it met today in Jesus' name. And everybody shouted, amen. One more time, give the Lord a hand clap of praise.
Someone said a boy is a loud sound covered in dirt. But is that really true? God wants boys to be boys. The church's job is not to hardware them differently, but to instill biblical software into their lives that will channel their natural assertiveness, competitiveness, and yes, loudness in a manner that honors Christ. As the church instills biblical principles of manhood and servant leadership skills into the lives of boys and young men, God-pleasing husbands, fathers, and world changers will emerge. Boys emulate men they admire and respect. The Apostle Paul instructs that godly men in the church play a role in bringing boys into biblical manhood, Titus 2, 6-8. The process starts ideally in a loving home and is reinforced with the active involvement of godly men. If we could take their motto from 1 Corinthians 11:1, it would be, "Follow me as I follow Christ." Men working with a purpose. Royal Rangers provides a ministry that is designed to encourage the men in your congregation to model the principles Jesus taught and be involved in service. It rallies them around a biblical cause. It provides them the resources to enjoy ministry success while developing much-needed bonds of friendship with other men. Royal Rangers is fun for both men and boys. To facilitate the mentoring relationship, Royal Rangers exercises the interest men and boys already have, like outdoor and sporting activities, trades, technologies, and art ministry. Royal Rangers uses proven mentoring resources to help boys become godly, confident, wise, and compassionate leaders. Royal Rangers is fun with a purpose. By intentionally developing the mentoring relationship, Royal Rangers equips the next generation of men, husbands, fathers, businessmen, and church leaders, and empowers them to be lifelong servant leaders. The boys and young men just think they're having fun instead of being discipled. Royal Rangers equals evangelism and discipleship. Yes, it's true that boys are often loud and covered in dirt, but boys don't have to be quiet and clean before coming to Christ. He can turn dirty noisemakers into articulate proclaimers of truth. He can prepare them to take the gospel to the next generation. All it takes are willing men to engage in meaningful mentoring relationships with them, influencing more boys and young men than ever, more effectively than ever. Royal Rangers, evangelizing, equipping, and empowering the next generation of Christ-like men and servant leaders.